This is gonna be really interesting.
Yeah, they thought I was the guy to lead with. That was their move.
Good luck to you guys.
Oh yeah, thank you so much. I can't wait. I'm so fucking good at Tory Bash. Yeah. Go me. All right. So this is a nerve wracking. No, it's fine. So my strategy is to score more points than him, and at the same time, I really want to make sure he doesn't score points. And finally, when I do have a lot of points, I'd like to make sure that he doesn't have the chance to hit me again. And that's how I'm coming into this, everyone. Typically, the player with the most points at the end of the match wins. Sound like freaking Steve Madden. John Madden, even.
What
would you rather listen to, Deepav?
Oh yeah, I am. Got this. I've got this hard, long, hard, and fast. It's a good thing we led with Brushu. Oh goodness gracious, he's thinking of making it one mod, one player. Good, I want to play all of the Brushu matches. I want to be responsible for that. Okay. Let's play some Lushu. I don't even know who they will even use for the Lushu.
I have no idea. I've never seen US's play except for Pain, and that was when he was in another clan.
They're a bunch of duelers.
Yeah.
They're a bunch of really good duelers. So, I mean, I expect a difficulty in Aikido, but anything can happen in Lushu, and I don't know any of these players.
So you're just sitting in there and waiting for someone to play?
Apparently, according to I'm a Pirate, they said that they're intimidated right now and they won't even enter a player. This is.
And they're all speaking Russian, so we don't know what they're saying.
Dude, I really need to take a poop, so they need to hurry their ass up. Okay, I think we're gonna fucking start. I hope.
So it is.
They're having a really hard time dealing with my username. Oh, I'm Versin, the pain.
Oh, cool, yeah.
Alright. Let's do it.
If you want to mute me, mute me. So that you want here.
One thing I'm never gonna do is hit space before the time expires, because I don't want to give any tells via my reaction time.
Yeah.
That's something I like to do in a competitive setting.
Troll dicks.
All right.
Okay.
Additionally, I'm gonna win.
So it looks like Hex is gonna win.
Typically I like to win the psychological warfare. And I do that with my mind.
So it looks like Hex is just gonna set up a defensive opener.
I know that he's going to outwardly burst, I just don't know how and when, so I need to like keep myself in a position where I can't score too many points.
So it looks like Hex is gonna go for a chest kick. and try to absorb as much damage from those legs as he can.
He's completely off. I'm not doing that. He's a terrible commentator. Yeah, see? That's how we do it, up in the hood.
And Hex has totally turned the table.
Feeling dominant early in this match.
And now, Payne's probably going to contract his elbow and try to grab his knee.
Well, that sucks, because he's too busy losing. And now, I'm in the air, so I don't like that at all.
So now Hex is probably going to have to try to get to the ground in a reasonable position to either dodge or do something to Payne when he comes in two turns. Or three.
I'm definitely gonna run. That's what's happening next. Now, I like to not run when I can. Pro tip. Okay.
And so it looks like this might be the end of Hex's head.
Negative.
No?
No. No. Yeah, okay. Maybe.
And now Hex is likely going to extend this knee and kick Payne with that knee and more or less contract that elbow. Or raise his shoulder.
Okay, that's an issue.
Why not?
Alright, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna snudge this. So what that means is I always contract my neck, because contracting your neck immediately causes you to win. So that's the plan for today. I'm not winning right now, and if he wants, I don't have to be winning in the future, because he could easily just disappear. That would be a very Russian thing to do.
Okay, and now Payne's most likely going to launch towards Hex, and
that'd be neat.
Hex is going to have to defend the oncoming attack from Payne.
Yeah, that's what I gotta do.
Because he's off balance and there's not enough time to set up an attack, I don't think.
You are correct, sir. Thank you for announcing that to the world.
That's alright.
Oh, good. Okay, so as you can see, I'm a little bit butt-fucked in this situation. Quite literally, actually.
So he's literally butt-fucked?
However, I can un-butt-fuck myself if I believe in the power of friendship. No, but in all reality, I'm not too concerned right now. There's still a lot of game left to be played. I'm just taking my time. The one thing you never want to do in a duel is force opportunities when it doesn't exist. So just absorb the hits as best as you can. You can notice that I put all of the damage into my hip, so that I didn't do much. I'm still well within the chance of winning this game.
Yeah.
And I'm in perfect comeback position, so I can get him pretty quickly.
Yeah, you've kept the score down well enough to actually have a chance of coming back and taking something from it.
Again, I like to strike with psychological warfare.
So yeah, you're gonna bring your knee around?
Yeah, we're gonna do a little stabbers style setup. Typically very convoluted, but in the end incredibly effective at scoring a bullshit amount of points when it counts. Yeah, I'm feeling pretty confident right now, actually. And now I'm not. So, based off turn frames... Alright, I'm smelling what I'm stepping in right now. I'm picking up what I'm putting down on myself. Alright, I got an idea. I think I can do this.
That's gonna be very close.
It's a sacrifice of points versus not DQing. God damn it, now.
Oh, so close.
Yeah. Oh boy. Well, that's a bummer. Oh. That's okay. I believe in the snudge.
So the first point goes to USSR.
Correct.
So it looks like Snudge is just going to set up an opener, a basic comeback, or he's just going to extend this wrist and bounce towards him and set up a knee.
Yeah, this is actually Snudge's most competitive opener. If he's opening with this, it's typically his like best go-to move.
Yeah. Is that because it's got the chest rotation or the kick?
Jackets just feels very comfortable with his legs, to be honest. Or, excuse me,
Snatch, yeah.
Feels very comfortable with his legs. He can play very defensively from this position, as you're seeing right now.
Yep.
He is a defensive player by nature, but he likes to keep his distance.
Yeah. So now he can easily extend his left knee and hit Pain in the lower chest, and hopefully block with his elbow.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
Alright, like I wish I knew. Snudge is not in a fantastic position right now. That's okay.
Might be the nerves.
Yeah. Like I said, we're all gonna take some time to feel comfortable in this situation. But hey, look, I'm on Snudge's leg texture.
Yeah.
That's a thing.
Yeah, but Snudge is like very good at just staying still and the overall control that he has.
Yeah, I mean it's just a matter of comfortability. USSR feels very, very comfortable in this situation because they are a bunch of duelers.
Yep.
Whereas Alpha typically isn't.
Yep.
We only have one real dueler. Two if you count Winver, but I don't really know what he does because he speaks in Russian.
Oh, does he duel as well?
He Russians. Okay, this is
beautiful. Okay, this is good. Really good.
For Snudge.
So he can extend his left elbow and kick Pain in the chest.
I would aim for his glutes, actually. I'd score a lot of points off his glutes.
Oh, yeah.
There's
just try to hit him in the hip, between the hip and the glutes. And try to get a dismember or something. Oh
wow. That's robbed.
That's a pretty good absorb.
Yeah, I mean, I've never seen this Pain guy before, but he is really, really good at point mitigation, as you saw against me.
Yeah.
Of course, I was at the great lead. I should have just ran from that point. launch yourself to victory. GM Tony for Shidoku Showdowns. There you go. If anyone wants to do that instead. Alright, so... if I were Snudge, I would just make sure not to fracture my wrist.
It doesn't look like he will because he's taking it pretty slowly.
No, I mean when he makes the comeback. Because he's probably going to take contracted risk to the comeback.
I mean, it is Brushu, isn't it?
It is Brushu, but...
But yeah.
When you need the game to make sense and work, it
doesn't. It doesn't, yeah. It just totally plays against you.
Yeah, we're seeing it right now. Alpha is currently the 0-1 in Brushu.
Yeah. So now Snudge will probably play it safe and more than likely do a short comeback to about here. Black sending his elbows and wrists.
Snudge actually, unlike you, takes long leaps. So you might not... it looks like he bunny hopped out of safety, but typically he'll go for it. If I were in any position and I had to say which one I liked more, it'd probably be Snudge. It looks like he's going to get the ground first and be underneath Pain, which is good.
Yeah.
Because he's just low enough that he can get the momentum that he needs, but high enough that he's not in any DQ risk.
I'm not
and
sure.
I've quickly changed. God damn, I hate how Pain is setting up his knees. It's making it a very, very difficult to score.
Just to score, just because he's blocking so well.
He is. He's got amazing blocking mitigation going on here. It's something that most USSR players have. In fact, that's why Winver is so fucking deadly at Wushu.
Yeah.
I think Pain's got the upper hand on this one, but we'll see.
He might be able to... because he can rotate his chest, so he should be able to hit Snudge's shin.
What a bummer.
Ah. So Snudge is going to have to set up really fast if he wants to do this.
I don't think Pain's going to let it happen. When you got 100 frames left, you're not going to give the person the win.
Yeah.
Okay, so Snudge can get his arm around. He can darn it.
Okay, so that's 2-0 to USSR. And both Brushu. So who's next? I'm a pirate that wants to.
It's either gonna be me or I'm a pirate. I'm letting him.
Okay, he's in.
Okay. No, I believe in him. Let's let the dueler duel. Just everyone calm down. Look how calm Pirate is compared to everyone else in the clan.
Yeah, he just carries on as normal.
Ooh, Pirate? Yeah, dueler. They can do that. I don't have that ability. It looks like Pirate's just kind of mind fucking Pain right now and doing things he doesn't need to. Snudge just made sure to let Pirate know that he has to show no mercy. Is anyone else getting mass lag?
Yeah, I am.
Yeah.
There we are. Oh, man. I believe in the pirate.
I think Pain will block this and then we'll have another chance to actually kick Pirate. Because if Pirate kicks, then he's going to cause himself to take damage.
Oh, my good Jesus, this guy is too fucking good at keeping his leg shut. He's like the opposite of a whore.
But now if Payne doesn't get out of there, then his head's gonna be in the way. So he's probably gonna dodge.
Boom.
Oh, nice.
Beautiful.
And a pirate can keep that up. Just keep the lead.
Beautiful. If Pirate can win this, and we end up using Winver, we'll be at a pretty large advantage because they won't be able to use Pain for the next mod, and we'll be 2-2.
Is Pain gonna go 4-4? Four.
It appears that way. He's played 3 in a row.
He's probably the only, well, their best, theoretically, their best pusher.
I don't know. I haven't seen him. It looks like... Dude, Pirate is just tearing shit up. He just improv'd 44.66 on that. I'm beyond impressed.
Drawing dicks.
Yeah. I don't know if you guys have the speedometer open, but you probably should for your stream.
True.
Oh my god, Pirate just fucking taking it home, man. Really, really good work. What I think the takeaway is, though, from watching Pain play, is that there is a real art to just covering the fucking legs up, man. I'm definitely gonna work with that a little bit more now that I've seen him, how he does it. I'm gonna watch those replays over again.
Yep.
It is hard as shit to score points against Pain. No one scored more than 20,000 or 25,000 or something.
Yep.
I think I scored 28,000 and I got a headshot.
Yeah. I mean, like, even now, how he is setting up right now, he's gonna be in a defensive position.
I think Pirate was going for the defensive backwards helicopter.
Yeah.
Otherwise known as a run. yeah. There's just so much to be learned about how Payne's playing right now. There's a lot of damage mitigation going on.
Yeah.
I'm very Russian in that account. I like to play defense, and it seems like these guys have figured out a way to do both.
Yeah. I mean, to be honest, like, he's not straight up offensive, which is, like, more attractive in a way. Like it's nicer to watch.
Yeah, of course, but that being said, the game isn't about being pretty.
Yeah, I know,
a lot of relax all players are just like, fucking style, or whatever the words they say, but, like, at the end of the day, if your quote-unquote style isn't bringing you wins at the most optimal level possible, then it's not style, it's a handicap.
Yeah, I know, but you can be aggressive, and then you can be, like, really controlled about it as well, so that you can direct yourself to it. To get more points, instead of being aggressive and going head first and stuffing yourself each time.
Yeah, I mean, I think it just shows, like, the people who play a lot, they just have such control over their bodies. You can see the weirdest changes in joints being made. Mm. Almost don't make sense to you. Like, I don't understand why Pirate's knee is relaxed right now, but it is. I don't know why his wrist isn't extended, but it's not.
And once again, Payne's just straight up defensive. And he's sitting up.
Oh, shit.
It doesn't look too bad.
Draw! For fuck's sake! You don't play! Why did we even use this fucking tool? Seriously, like, just try to predict stuff. This is a commentating tool, and the whole deal was just to make sure that fucking useful and this is how to make Torbash spectating interested in shit. Don't just, you know.
Just talking about it.
Torbash isn't interesting. The game's terrible. Don't play it. If you like not playing Torbash, like, comment, and subscribe to Torbash Takeover.
This is not Torbash Takeover. This is, what's it even called, like?
Yeah, so Armor Pirates just secure the win, which is nice. So what's that now? That's 1-2 to...
that's 1-2-1.
So you're saying that Winver's playing next, is he?
Hopefully. Because I don't wanna. Most optimally, I would like to win Clan League and take credit for it whilst doing absolutely nothing.
As little as you can.
I really don't want to.
You know, you don't just want to stuff it up, like.
Yeah, I've never won a Clan League match before. I've only been in one clan that's participated in Clan League, and that was for Clan League number 3.
Yep.
So I don't have like a great experience with it. Yo, pirate, spec. Yeah, alright, we're putting our evil pants out.
I've actually never seen him play Winver.
He's really, really unbelievable, actually. I don't know if you guys remember the great Wushu tournament hosted by Team Wushu. But I mean, he beat amazing players by great scores. 5-2 against Powas, 5-4 against Snudge, and then 5-0 in the finals, winning against Begotten.
Well, that's crazy.
No, I totally don't remember.
That's crazy.
Yeah, what you're seeing right now from Winver is very typical. He likes to stay in like a helicopter state. And he's very, very, very good at just kind of reversing his actions, so he can just kind of switch sides right now if he wants to, like a breakdancer. He only strikes with his legs, though. He's very, very strike with his legs only player.
Yeah, but that's really good for like point wise.
Yes, and his point wise, he is the most defensive player. I think being pretty, because I think this is a cool way to play.
Yep.
I mean, there are 1.5 million players that are playing relaxed and like flailing and doing the high speed shit. This is what real art's about.
Just the straight control. Just knowing what you're gonna do.
Our kind of strategy is now bribing them. Yeah, what you're seeing from Winver is super, super common.
What's he doing? Is he just playing it safe, or is he?
He's really just working with his legs, man. You're seeing a lot of leg manipulation. You're gonna probably see a twist or a turn, and you know, it's always hard to say because Payne's definitely coming for the comeback this turn. Yeah. A lot of very low scoring games. I'm very nervous though, because I feel like Payne can get a headshot on here.
Yeah. I don't think he'll let it happen though.
I don't see Winver coming out on top in terms of points right now. Oh.
Wow.
See? It's all legwork, man.
That's
really,
crazy.
Really defensive. They know something I don't in terms of points. They really did. Like, they got it leaked by Hampa or something. I don't know what to tell you. But you can see it's just all legwork and simple concept.
Yeah.
But we're having a good Clan League so far. 2-1 is not a bad start.
Yeah.
I was obviously hoping for a bigger lead via Brushu, but you know, it's Brushu. Well, that is unbelievable. I did not expect that happening at all.
Yeah, I was expecting that to make a comeback, you know, the setup properly.
That was really fucking fast. I'm curious if Winver will finally choose to strike with his left arm or not. Oh, he did. He almost never punches. So I guess he finally recognized that this was an appropriate time to do so.
So it's probably really unlikely to see a head hit on him. On Winver.
It's very unlikely. It's very unlikely to see a head hit on a Russian. You're seeing their play style right now. No points over 20,000. It's like, it's very defensive, but it's what works to win.
Yep.
Oof. Scaring the shit out of me. I have to say, for the amount of shit that Russians get for, like, being cheating, whatever, Payne is playing as fair as possible.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, almost to a fault.
Yeah. Hey, he's one of those guys. Like, whenever I've played him, he's always been like that.
Yep, see? You're just seeing all that fucking leg manipulation.
I think I might start playing like Winver. We'll try to...
It takes a long time, man. It takes a long time. But you're seeing its benefits. I mean, playing like Winver and Payne, you're seeing how it plays out in terms of score.
Yeah, yeah. That's just because I've never seen them play like this. Like going Winver for the points, going for the win.
Winver is a tier 1 player. He absolutely is.
Yeah, yeah.
100%.
Easily.
Payne probably is too, to be quite honest with you. This is just really, really beautiful work by him. I fear that Payne probably is going to have to...
He's going to have to run away.
Yeah. I mean, he doesn't have to, but he would lose otherwise. Like, he could just contract his hip, but that would lead his head forward.
Yes! that's so unlucky.
Okay. Wow. That was legitimately bad luck.
Yeah.
And I'm really curious to see who we're going to use for Tekion. I'm really hoping it's not me.
Damn. Okay, so that's 2-2. 2-2 Alpha. 2-2 USSR.